नमो तस्स भगवतो अरहतो सम्मा संबुद्धस्स। नमो तस्स भगवतो अरहतो सम्मा संबुद्धस्स। नमो तस्स भगवतो अरहतो सम्मा संबुद्धस्स। So, dear friends, your right palm on your left, neck head straight in one line, and be comfortable with your posture. And let your whole body settle down itself and focus your mind to head to toes. And say Supatveva or be well and happy 3 times. Scan head to toes yourself and say may I be well and happy. Oh Supatveva. So take a moment and think, we gathered here in this moment to practice this ancient meditation technique. All the Buddhas, all the enlightened masters followed this path and achieved wisdom. We also gathered here to accumulate that knowledge. In this moment with this sitting, may my body become more comfortable, may my breath be more smooth, may no difficulties come to me, may all the success come to me. Also think for a moment, this is the last moment we are spending in this very lifetime, and detach your mind from all your past memories and as well as any kind of future thoughts. Just try to remain in the present moment, observing your inhalation and exhalation. So in the beginning, mentally relax your body step by step. Relax your head, relax your forehead, relax your eyebrows, eyes, relax your ears, relax your nose and relax your whole face muscles. Relax your teeth, relax your tongue, relax your mouth. Relax your throat and relax your neck. Relax your shoulders, arms, elbow, forearms, palms, fingers, fingertips. Relax your whole back muscles and relax your spine. Relax your chest and relax your abdominal muscles. Relax your lungs, relax your heart, liver, kidneys, relax your gallbladder, relax your pancreas, relax your small intestine, relax your large intestine, relax your all abdominal organs, relax your buttock, relax your thigh, relax your knee. Relax your calf muscles. Relax your foot and relax your toes. Relax your whole body muscles, tendons, ligaments, bone marrows, and whole skeleton. Release the tension in your mind and keep relax your face muscles. And also remember, when you want to relax your mind, one thing you have to relax is your tongue and relax your mouth. So that way, naturally, you allow that the blood to flow from neck to your head area. So remember that. Another thing is, when you practice meditation, remember to develop unmovable posture. So don't move your body. And intentional, desirable attention. Don't just sit and close your eyes, nothing going to happen. Intensely, you have to observe and recognize your own experience, what is happening inside you. So that experience will lead you to next step. So today we're going to observe our inhalation, exhalation. And we're going to observe it in front of our nose and our upper lip area. Okay, this area. And so don't try to do anything. Don't try to inhale or exhale. Don't try to hold your breathing. Don't try to think about it. Don't try to maintain it. Don't try to count. Just let it happen naturally. So in the beginning, deeply and gently breathe in, breathe out 3 times and recognize the sensation. So now bring your attention to in front of your nose and your upper lip area and observe the inhalation, exhalation naturally. Just allow it to happen itself. And through the sensation, recognize this is inhalation, this is exhalation. Do nothing extra. So time to time, observe your posture also. If you hold the wrong posture, you're not going to get the sensation. So newcomers, if you are a beginner, it is okay to spend few times to find the right posture. How you can do it? And try to slowly move your upper body, this back and forth little bit, and find the right place where you can keep your head. Another one is moving your head little bit up and down. Now find the right place that where you get the sensation. Once you get it, don't move your body. Let everything to settle down as it is. Recognize this is inhalation, this is exhalation, through the sensation of it. Do nothing extra. And observe the entire continuation with that, from beginning to end. Observe whole breath body. Inhalation, this is the beginning, this is the middle, this is the end. Exhalation, this is the beginning, this is the middle, and this is the end. So from beginning to end, observe. Keep follow the sensation. Some inhalation become longer, shorter, heavy, soft, warm, or cold. Sometimes only right nostril inhale, sometimes left inhale. So don't try to do anything, just observe how it happens. Each and every inhalation, exhalation unique and has a different character. Just recognize it. Let go your old thoughts, stay with the inhalation, exhalation. Sometimes your own thoughts can disturb. Don't follow that. Stay with inhalation, exhalation. Let everything to unfold itself. Within your own inhalation, exhalation experience, moment by moment, its change. Following your inhalation, exhalation, your body and your mind change. Your body and mind not listen to you. It listen to, it follow your own inhalation, exhalation. That is, your body and mind can understand only the language of your inhalation, exhalation. If you don't know the rhythm of the inhalation, exhalation, if you don't know the nature of the inhalation, exhalation, you don't know about life. Your inhalation gives you the life. Your life starts with your inhalation, exhalation. Your life going to end with your inhalation, exhalation. Just observe its own nature. Then you will see it arise itself, exist for a moment and disappearing. Everything change moment by moment. Everything in a journey. So learn to go with that journey. Follow your inhalation, exhalation. Once you experience it really to the highest, you come out of becoming nature and you drop all this collective nature and there is nothing to let go inside you. When there is nothing to let go, there is nothing to resist, there is nothing come against you, there is nothing to go against. That is where you drop all the anger, hatred, jealousy, envy, unsatisfaction. By thinking, you cannot come out of it. But once you understand the true nature of your life, There is nothing to do. It itself happens. Just observe. So bring your attention to your body and observe this moment and appreciate yourself. How lucky you are to be like this in this very moment. Pay your gratitude to this world. You have a moment to sit and observe yourself. There are a lot of people don't have it. In this very moment, there are a lot of people fighting with death, struggling with their own life. There are a lot of people have the fear, anxiety, depression, and they go through hopelessness, helplessness, and loneliness. They are fighting with the illness and the disease. So have a thought yourself to share your heart with all of them, wherever they are. May they come out of that struggle, may they come out of that fear, anxiety, depression, may they come out of that illness or the disease, may they come out of that loneliness, helplessness, or hopelessness. May they have the strength and courage to stand themselves and experience the tranquility state within themselves. And not only that, share your heart with your loved ones. Your husband, your wife, children, friends and family members, brothers, sisters, parents, and with your neighbors, your village people, your city, your state, your country, around this world. And not only that, as far as you can through galaxies, other planets, stars. Let your heart to shine with the loving kindness and compassion from the bottom of it with the maximum effort to the highest. So with that intention, mentally repeat after me. May all living beings in this universe be well and happy. May everyone be happy and safe. And may their hearts be filled with joy. May all living beings live in security and in peace. Beings who are frail or strong, tall or short, big or small, visible or not visible, near or far away, already born or yet to be born, may all of them dwell in perfect tranquility. Let no one do harm to anyone. Let no one put the life of anyone in danger. Let no one, out of anger or ill will, wish anyone any harm. Expand the loving kindness and compassion, beginning from your heart. Visualize yourself and send it as a light. So we do step by step. forward. To your backside. To your left side. And to your right side. Downward. And upward. All six directions at once, like the moon, the sun, spread the light. Let your heart to shine without any limitation, without any judgment, and without any resistance. Let your heart to shine with the loving kindness and compassion. Say sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. See, so dear Dhamma friends, nowadays most of you hear some medical words, and at the same time there is a word people hear, intensive care. So when somebody go to intensive care, that means that person needs some special attention. And sometimes there is a situation difficult to handle in ordinary way. It needs to take some special effort. And not only that, when any person go to intensive care, there are some doctors or the nurses use a different way to treat them. It's not like in an ordinary ward. So sometimes our life also the same. Sometimes ourselves, we are in intensive care. Maybe you are like that, maybe your family members, other people like that. So when somebody in a family, sometimes in intensive care means, what I'm trying to mention, they need special attention. Maybe you are the one who can do that. So you become kind of like a doctor. You become kind of like a nurse. And there are a lot of things that you have to do, and not in an ordinary way. That is the important thing. In ordinary way that people cannot going to come out of it. In ordinary way, if you try to treat them, the situation going to become more worse. So then you have to be very careful in day-to-day life. Why? Because there is a human nature. The most of human beings need attention. There are a lot of people lose it. And there are a lot of people don't care. You know, we live together as a husband, wife, children, friends and family members, brothers, sisters. You know, even look around the world. It doesn't matter whoever, wherever you go, whoever you become. People always, most of time, look for attention. It's a kind of like a innocent fundamental human, you know, nature, quality. You cannot judge it. You cannot criticize it. That is important sometimes. Even during the Buddha's time, you know, the Buddha went to different people and putting special attention and giving sometimes waiting for that person, like you know, Angulimala and Kasi Bharadwaja, you know, Daniya Gopala, you know, there are a lot of people, and the Buddha went to them again and waiting for them and put the attention to recover them from that situation. Otherwise himself, he doesn't, you know, go to a place and start to preach Dharma, you know. And sometimes your loved ones, you know, your husband, your wife, your children, your brother, sister, your parents, it is very easy to disconnect. But ourselves, how we can become kind of like a doctor to, you know, treat them like the patient in intensive care. You have to be so gentle, you have to be so careful, and you have to be so mellow, you have to be so soft and relaxed. You know, you cannot be kind of like a tough, you know, that the military person trying to handle the prisoners. Like that way, you cannot handle people. So this is, you know, the quality that you have to develop in everyday life. The one thing is you have to know, because otherwise you're not going to behave that way. You have to know the very first thing. Everybody need certain attention. So while you are at home, you know, wherever you are, and try to, you know, share your life with that, especially with your husband, wife, children, and family members. You know, that connection is more important. And once you take that responsibility, how, in ordinary life, it will help you to share your life and become a better person. And how it's going to help for you to develop your spirituality? Because the mind also the same. You know, when you observe this inhalation, exhalation, what you recognize in, there is nothing solid. There is nothing rough. You know, there is nothing can come to a form. No, everything in liquid. So that is a nature you can observe and recognize inside you. And once you recognize that nature, you become more soft and relaxed yourself. Sometimes we abuse our own life most of the time. There are a lot of people, you know, they become so hard on them without any reason, even not for a profitable skill. You know, they not for a profitable reason. Some, there are certain moments you have to be hard on you for a higher purpose. But there are people sometimes become hard and abuse their own life. There are a lot of people hate themselves. You know, there are no need any virus come to them and, you know, and give a hard time. Their own mind create a different kind of, you know, the unnecessary thoughts, and they suffer inside them, and they're not going to open to anything or anybody, and they close inside them and keep suffering. They addicted to suffer. That is so dangerous. And that's why, you know, when you look at the today world, there are a lot of people get into depression, anxiety. You know, why it can happen like that way? Why you so depending, you know, from this outside world? You have the life. That is the most important thing. You have ability to breathe in. You know, you have ability to understand things. That is the life. You know, that not the other people, whoever, whatever put into our shoulder, and not whatever other people push us to do, is not your life. You are living. You are just be. You know, this, so that is the important thing. Have you, without appreciate that, if you start to look certain things, and you will never find it. So remember, be soft on you, be relaxed on you, be calm on you, never abuse you. You know? If you can feel the inhalation, exhalation, that is the most beautiful thing that you can have in this world. When the inhalation, exhalation going to disappear, it doesn't matter wherever you are, whatever you have, you know, that everything going to detach from you. Nothing going to be with you. So remember this, everything to us, all this universal, you know, the connection bring to us through the inhalation, exhalation. That is the link. Appreciate it. If you have that, that is enough. Don't complain regarding life. Don't abuse yourself. Don't go with any hard things. So learn to appreciate yourself and learn. That's why every day when I start meditation, I tell one word, you know, that put your, you know, attention with the intention. So that intention means you need a special care. It's like a patient go to intensive care. So you are meditating mean you putting your consciousness, awareness to a special care regarding your own mind or your own life. That is very needed. When you able to put a certain attention yourself and take care yourself, you are a person that can help others. You are a kind of like a doctor can go to intensive care. You are a person kind of, you know, you are a person kind of like a doctor can go in emergency situation and help your family members. So remember, each and every person need attention. So bring that attention yourself and develop it within inside you. And whenever other people need it, start to share it with them little bit. And in a different ways, you know, just by little bit sitting with them, you know, and just by, you know, talking little bit and just, you know, and sharing something with them. But the key point you have to remember, you know, that the king to the beggar, you know, president to the ordinary person, you know, rich person to the poor person, you know, seeker to the enlightened master, this everybody, you know, that the living as, you know, the community, you know, the communion you have to build up mean, you know, the interconnection each and everyone. So that you have that power within yourself. So then uplift yourself to that, to become, build up the communion. The, in that communion level, you know, the community means you with the intention, you have a same intention to work for certain thing. When it become a communion without any words, without any work, just appearing yourself, other people start to feel comfortable. Be kind of like that person. When other people see you, they feel more comfortable, they feel protective, they feel happy, they feel more peace and calm. Be a person like that. As a husband, wife, when you see each other, if other person feel unpleasant, unhappy, sad, worry, you know, what's the point? Your own husband or your own wife, when you see, you know, if they feel unhappy, what's the point you having this life? If your own children, when they see you as a parent, if they're not happy, what's the point? Even as parents, when you see your children, you know, if you are not happy, what's the point? There is something wrong. So as human beings, each other, when we see, if we don't feel the comfort, remember there is something missing. What is that point? What is that missing point? Because we don't care. That's why. If you start to care, you know, when you see other people, they never going to feel disconnection. They start to feel the connection deeper in their heart. So then start to care about other people. That is not enough. It needs to start within yourself. Start to take care of yourself. And intensely, you know, not by mistake or not because of that or this, intensely start to care yourself and put attention to you. No, never abuse your life. Always protect your life. And then start to put attention to others. Care regarding other people. Then look for their needs. And that way, you become kind of like a healer. So today, it's very needed to this world. And you are the one who can do it. Don't wait till somebody else is going to do it. You know, there are a lot of doctors, as you know, in this moment, in the intensive care, in the hospital, they work so hard. Why? There are a lot of people dying. And at the same time, at home, yourself. Remember, be like a doctor, be like a healer. Why? Even you don't see. Sometimes your husband, your wife, your children, your parents, brothers, sisters, deeper in their heart, they die with every breath, every moment along themselves. So give little healing to them. Protect them a little bit. Take care of them. Share your life. And if you can do it for one person in this lifetime as a human being, you will fulfill these human qualities. You will uplift this humanity. So it is in your hand. It is your true nature. You have the strength to do that. Believe that you can do it. And start to work it with for your loved ones. Before you start to put your hand to your unhappy people, start to do it with your loved ones. Start to do it with your friends and family members. Once it becomes a profitable quality, once it becomes a skill, even your enemies, when they come to in front of you, they feel more secure and comfort and happy and love. Even not the human beings, any animal, if they come to you, they also feel the security and the love coming from your heart. So try it. Without trying, you will never understand what this is. But if you try for a moment, you will see what I mean. So I wish upon everyone. With this, may all of you be well, happy and peaceful. May no harm come to you. May no difficulties come to you. May all the happiness and success be with you. And everyone stay healthy and safe. Sabbityo vajjantu sabbaro ko vinasatu mate bhavatantarayo suki diga yuko bhava. Ettavata chamme sampadam punya sampadam sabbe deva sabbe bhuta sabbe satta numodantu sabba sampatti. Idamme punya kammanga savakkaya vahan hotu sabba dukkha pamuchatu. So bless you.